So people know that I have all the answers, right?
No,
nobody knows that.
Nobody has all the answers.
Didn't y'all say that?
No, nobody said that.
You guys were always saying, ask Neems. He knows everything.
No, because you think you know everything.
Sarcastic way.
Yeah, you think you know it all.
Good enough for me.
Okay.
So, we're going to do life advice.
All right. I was with my girlfriend late at work last night. Her message tone went off, and as a curious mind, I go to look who it was because it was late. She immediately grabbed the phone and put it in her pocket and refused to show me after I asked twice. I'm leaning towards leaving her because that was just wrong and she shouldn't have any problem with me seeing her phone unless she's hiding something. I would like to hear your advice on this soon.
Leave. Trust is very difficult.
The trust's already broken.
It's already broken.
It's broken.
It's gone.
You're done.
If you have to worry about... It's already too late.
Yeah, you don't want to do that. That's true. You don't want to be the guy that goes,
I've always looked at phones, too, though, as like they are really private matters.
Sure.
Yeah.
Just find out. Does that person want to be with you? If she is doing something secretive, talk about it. Communicate.
Yeah, communication is
But don't
key.
Be jealous.
No.
Nobody likes a jealous person.
Yeah, be honest. Yeah. It's not the end of the world if you break up.
Right. No. Yeah, and ask yourself, why did you look at that phone?
You don't want to spend your whole life policing your relationship.
No. Nope. That sounds god awful.
Yeah, and I might be the wrong person to ask because I'm just irresistible.
Right.
Women are just like all in my business. I'm like, just give me some space.
Yeah, you're like a
prune
magnet.
Yep.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that once jealousy's in the picture, it's kind of bye-byes.
So this guy has two choices. One, deal with it.
Yep.
Just say, that person needs a bit of privacy. I'm going to respect that and trust they're doing the right thing.
Yeah, because they're with you.
Yep. Or two, just say, I can't live this way.
Yes. Hey, Neebs and crew, in regards to your latest Facebook post, I wanted to ask what keeps you motivated and how did you find the thing that keeps you motivated to keep making videos, especially when you started YouTube?
For me, it's like when we get those emails or we get those messages, like someone is having a really shitty day.
Mm-hmm.
And they found our video, and it just brightened them up. Like, that's what motivates me, like, because that's what I want to bring to the world. I just want to make somebody happy for a day.
Yeah, just the fact that they actually like our dumbasses. That's pretty motivating. Yeah.
You have to identify what it is you want to stay motivated about, and it's usually something you have passion for. So figure out what that is, write it down, put it somewhere where you can see it every day, and if you're doing it already, getting results, you know, if you do it and people appreciate it, that's a good way to stay motivated. But measuring your progress, making sure you're getting closer to that thing you're trying to work towards.
You know, you got to make it your priority to focus on what you need to do and just go for it.
If you're trying to become a painter, you got to say, Tuesdays I paint regardless.
No matter what.
You know what? We've all had shitty jobs.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
We've all had very, So, you know, I definitely do not want to swing a hammer anymore.
Yeah. Always strive to do something you love.
Yes.
Here we go. Do you like porn with a storyline or just getting on with it?
Getting on with it.
I like getting on with it. I like real people. Like, some porn is just too overproduced.
If you want a good laugh, go for the storyline.
Oh, yeah. And the acting's horrible. Yeah. Oh, it's like nothing takes me out of a fucking porn like a fucking storyline.
Right. And I don't watch porn anymore.
I love the stuff. Well, Neebs, this girl I've known since sixth grade. I'm in ninth. We talk and I really love and want to be with her, but her dad is strict and doesn't want her dating, but we both love each other. What should I do to get her father to change his mind?
Can I start? You don't love each other.
Yeah, you don't.
You don't. You really like this girl.
You do.
You're not, and it's okay, man. We were all there.
Your little nuts are finally developed. You're ready to go. You're physically attracted to this girl. I get it. Yeah. I get it. We've all been there.
Dude, your wife hasn't even been born yet. I'm not kidding. Down.
There are high school sweethearts out there. It's okay for this person.
True.
Might date her for 6 years. You never know. It might work out. Don't think that this is the end all be all. It might be that way. You never know.
Odds
but it's
are
very
not.
Rare.
If you guys are hanging out and her dad's just talk, like get to know him.
Yeah.
And then maybe he'll let you go on a date or whatever down the road.
Because as a dad, he's looking at you like, look at this little kid.
Yeah.
He's just got his nuts. Just dropped. He's ready. He's ready to go. He's after my daughter. Fuck this little kid. Yeah. Little girl, you're going to be home at 9 o'clock tonight.
Befriend him. Win his respect.
I think the best advice for this kid is just wait it out.
Yeah. Okay, here we go. So this girl I'm talking to and potentially might date works as an exotic dancer. And I don't know if I should go through with it or not. Also, main reason that I don't know if I'm the jealous type. Help, Neebs.
If you're going into this relationship and she's a dancer, you need to assume that she wants to stay a dancer and you need to decide, can you live with that?
Yeah.
You shouldn't go into a relationship thinking how you're going to change somebody.
Nobody should, on either side.
And your mind will start to play tricks on you and start getting you all crazy jealous, I'm assuming.
Yeah, if you're a jealous... jealous type, I would say don't even try.
No.
I would also suggest that you become a dancer so you can relate.
There you go. My neighbors already put up Christmas decorations. Classic vandalism, like eggs to the door, is just boring. Got any good ideas? I've got the best idea.
What's that, Draz?
Well, vandalism's illegal. You don't want to get in trouble.
Right.
And it's just childish anyway. I would add to the decorations.
Every day, just put something new in the yard?
Yeah, like a little plastic reindeer over here. Spice it up, little by little.
Yeah.
Really cheesy?
Small stuff.
Like small, cheesy stuff.
Well, over
first.
The next few weeks, it's just like crap all over their yard.
Like all over.
I like that. Maybe even plant a couple trees in their yard.
Yeah, it's reverse.
No, don't do that.
Like just a little tree, a sapling.
Yeah. There you go, saplings.
Adding decorations is a lot of fun.
Yeah, reverse vandalism.
And document it, because I want to see it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes.
How do I get my fiance to have sex with me again? We just had a son, and time is tight. We never have the energy anymore. How do I lay my lady again?
Fiance just had a baby, man. The baby thing's weird because, there's nothing
you gotta
do.
Wait a little while after the baby.
You have to be patient.
Are we, like, talking a couple weeks
after?
Well,
that's what we don't know. Let's assume, say, a year. Let's look at it that way.
Yeah, the communication is going to be big. Talk to her about it.
Yeah.
You know, don't beat up around the bush or anything. Just
be
honest.
Yeah.
It's very hard sometimes, no pun intended. Once you go, you hit the 30 days. It's just been so long. It's just super hard, I've found, for the female. Sometimes the guy is just like, I want to go for it. It's hard for them to get into it. So it's got to be something that you almost got to muscle through, as horrible as it sounds. And you can't just jump back into wanting to bang.
Talk about it
for a woman
without whining. Because whiny does not make
you
attractive.
No, yeah.
No.
And you probably feel whiny because you haven't got a nut off. Get a babysitter, someone you trust. Have a wonderful evening with her.
Get a babysitter, then have a wonderful threesome.
And you know what? Expect no sex.
Expect no sex.
Right.
Expect no
just
sex.
Have a great night. And when you have sex with her next, go down there. You know, give her a nice, good O. Make it about her. Get her thinking about it differently.
You want to repeat customers, what you're saying.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. They got to enjoy the service and come back.
Find out what she needs. What can I do for you? Because it's going to seem like it's all about you if you're just asking for sex because I haven't had it in a while.
Yeah.
Be
and
her
look
partner.
At these blue balls.
It comes off as desperate.
They're almost black.
Mm-hmm. Let me throw out some bonus advice.
Bonus.
Sure.
I think sexual relationship also revolves around your life at the time.
Yep.
So look around your life and see what else is a wreck right now. Maybe it's finances. Maybe it's kids. Maybe it's jobs. Maybe it's the house. Maybe it's bills. Clean some of that up.
Sure.
And then that way, that frees up a person's mind from worry to let's get busy over here.
That's good bonus advice right there.
Great advice.
That's good boner advice. I like it.
My wife is pregnant and we are hoping for a girl. My friends and family don't like the name Abigail Love. What should I tell them so they will like the name?
What's this person's name?
Joe Hawk.
This is what I would tell Joe Hawk. Tell your family that you don't like the name Joe Hawk and deal with it.
Bam. Yeah, fuck the friends and family that don't like that name. This is you and your wife's decision.
Yeah, exactly. Really. It doesn't matter.
They have no say in it.
So fuck them.
Yeah.
Collectively, our advice is to tell your family to go fuck themselves.
Yeah, make your own decisions.
You're welcome.
Listen, once they meet Abigail Love, it's going to be the sweetest name they've ever heard.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. She's going to be a little button, unless she's an ugly baby.
As a U.S. Army vet, I've been struggling with PTSD for the last 5 years. This year, however, I've been self-medicating with marijuana to help with anxiety and depression, and it's worked wonders. Outside of the munchies, there are no side effects like I'd be experiencing with prescription drugs. I only smoke as needed when symptoms arise. I do it and stay in my own home, and I use no other kinds of narcotics. Marijuana use, however, is still stigmatized, and I've noticed that the VA in particular is aggressive against its use. What would you say would be the best way to deal with people that views vets like me in a negative way because we use alternative methods to help with symptoms of PTSD?
All you got to do really is wait for about 30 years for all these old fuckers to die out.
I think 10 years is going to be it.
I mean, you look at prescription drugs. We talked about this earlier. Prescription drugs have worse side effects than marijuana.
All those fucking opiates, like the VA. All the VA does is like they prescribe fucking opiates to people.
I think you... sir, are doing it right.
Yeah.
You're keeping it in the house. You don't have to deal with people. And as long as you're not getting drug tested somewhere and it's working for you, I'd say keep it up, you know?
And on top of that, thanks for your service.
Absolutely.
Yeah, man.
Fuck yeah.
You're doing it right, homie.
Hell yeah.
Next question. How are babies made?
Oh, good question.
Yeah.
Mm. Let's see. The man's ding dong goes into the schnooter.
Uh-huh.
And then there's sperm goes in the schnooter.
Uh-huh.
Makes the egg fertile.
Yeah.
Turns into a baby, comes out a little baby.
Good answer.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Did I cover everything?
Wait nine months. Yeah. You gotta wait. Doesn't come right away.
Oh, it's not immediate.
Wait 9 months.
It's not an easy bake oven or anything.
And then it gets pushed out of the snooter.
Right.
Yeah. And apparently that takes a lot of work too.
Yeah.
Now you know.
So there you go, guys. If you need life advice from us, leave your questions down in the comments.